Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Tiffany and this is Tiff and Stitches, my second time trying to film this video. So I've lost some of the light that I had. Hopefully everything is still good to go and you can see everything. It has been a while since I filmed, a little over a year actually. And I did a poll on Instagram a couple, like maybe about a month back, and said, hey, I can just kind of go off of the most recent stuff, or I can catch you guys all the way up over the past year, but it would be really long. And I was told that you guys preferred a long video. I'm not gonna lie, this is probably gonna be somewhere in the middle. I don't have everything here. I've gifted some things that I'm not gonna talk about. I've knit some socks that are in the laundry that I'm not gonna talk about, but I do have the bigger things, the garments, that kind of stuff. That we'll get into. I have my current whips. I have some acquisitions that are really recent, not dating all the way back to the last year because I've used a lot of the stuff since then. And then I have some future plans type things that I will talk about. Hopefully everything records this time. Fingers crossed that the video stays put. And otherwise, I don't know that I'm going to finish filming because I got all ready today. And if it fails again, I'm going to be discouraged. Life catch up. There's not really too much. I mean, there's a lot of things that are new, but it's kind of hard to catch you up over a whole year. I guess the biggest thing is that we're happy. We're healthy. Things are good. I've gotten a new job since I talked to you guys last. It's a little bit crazier than my job prior. I manage a lot of people and it's pretty high stress. So that's one of the reasons why I haven't filmed in such a long time, even though I have been knitting. It's just hard to kind of find the energy, I guess, but I'm trying to get back to the things that bring me joy, and I do enjoy filming and posting. So that's what we're doing. Without further ado, I'm gonna jump in and kind of just go through the bigger things that I finished in the past year or so. So I'm going to not go in any particular order because I don't honestly remember exactly the order that I knit things in, but I'm going to start with some older finished objects that you guys haven't seen in a video. If you follow me on Instagram, you've seen them, which my Instagram is Tiff and Stitches as well. But yeah, I'm just gonna show them here and we'll go from there. So this is it's a shawl. It's by Christy Archer Designs. It was a knit along with Knitty Natty over the summer, or like right before the summer, I want to say. I'll put the name of the pattern down below. I love this shawl, and it is knit with, I still have the labels, ironically enough. This is actually a friend of mine here in Houston. I don't know if she's still dying or not, but her name is Elise. Small batch yarns. I won this yarn in a giveaway, and it's actually a set. And it's chocolate chip, ice cream, and mint. So mint, chocolate chip, ice cream. Obviously, this is the mint color. The bits and pieces of brown that you see in there are chocolate chip. And then the main color of the shawl is ice cream. So it's just a pretty triangle shawl. And yeah, I love it. I wore it a couple of times this winter. And it's a really fun pattern. I knit this up really quick. I'm really enjoyed knitting it. So there's that. And then the next one that I know dates back, because it was a whip last time I filmed, is this Anchors Tee by Petite Knit that I knit out of Holskarn Super Soft. I have a cone of it right here, and it is the color Bleached White. I held it double to get gauge. I think I ended up having to change my needle size as well. The one thing I will say about this is that I knit it to the recommended size for my bust and to have a little bit of positive ease. And it is such a square shape that it kind of eats me whole on the bottom part. So I kind of wish I would have done some waist shaping, but I didn't at the time. So I still wear it. It is very, very warm. This is non-superwash wool. It's very warm. So here in Texas, it's hard to wear this, but it would be good for traveling as a layering piece, and I enjoyed knitting it, so I'm glad I have it. Okay, next I'm going to show you the test knit I did for perfectly knotted. It's called the Professor Pullover. This is the front. So I knit this for my son, for my oldest son, Carter, and it is a worsted weight sweater. It knit up super fast. I think I finished this sweater in like 2 weeks tops. It might have been a little less than 2 weeks. And such a cool pattern. I love the construction of it. It was an interesting raglan I hadn't done before, so I really enjoyed that. And this red is my son's favorite color, this son's favorite color, and so that's why we went with this stripe pattern. So these are by, I got this yarn on Etsy. It's from Treasure Goddess Yarn. This is her label right there. And there's obviously four colors in this. So the main color is called Gunpowder. So this dark gray, almost black, is Gunpowder. And then the orangey, coppery color is called Copper Cove. The red is called Ruby Daggers. And the gray, or the silver, is called Pieces of Eight. So those are the four colors I used in his sweater. I did go up a needle size to get gauge. I knit it in a 8 for the ribbing and a 9 for the body, US 8 and a US 9, which it calls for a US 7 and US 8. So I did go up. And the only thing I would have changed about this is I would have gone a little bit longer. My son probably will not get another winter out of this the way that it is now. So I'm going to have to either add some length. The sleeves are fine, but I think the body needs more length. So I'll have to figure that out. I have a little bit left of this gray, but not much. My mom knit a hat out of it for my brother. She got another skein though. I think there's a little bit left, but we'll have to see. So that's that. And then my little one needed a sweater and I couldn't quite follow the same pattern because she didn't have kids sizes. So I had to like use a kids just freebie raglan pattern and then just do the striping the same. So the neck is a little bit different. It was a different construction. But the overall concept is the same. So there's that. And then I used the same colors on his, except that I added the yellow because that's his favorite color instead of the red. And that color is called Poseidon's Trident by the same dyer. So he loves his sweater. He wears it a lot more than my older one wears his. And it fits him. It's a little oversized for him. So I did a better job when I knit this one of making sure it'll fit him for a little bit longer. The next thing I'm going to share is actually what I'm wearing. This is my So Faded sweater by Andrea Mowry. I did use a total of 3 different yarn dyers and 6 different colors in this fade. I had to use more, like I think the pattern gives you a 3 fade option and a 5 fade option. I had to use more because one of the sets of yarn I was using was a fade that was 50 grams each, and I would not have had enough if I only did 5 yarns, so I had to kind of figure out the math to do 6. But I did knit this with the recommended needle size. I got gauge, and the first color is from the fade set that I mentioned. It's from a Homespun house, and it is called First Snow. This is, if you haven't seen it, is Homespun house's labels, and it's called First Snow. The second color is by Sewrella Yarns and it's Mrs. Patmore's Kitchen. I got it as a sock set and you will see a pair of socks that I knit out of what I had remaining. The third color is actually really close to Mrs. Patmore's Kitchen, but it's like a tan color and it is called Roasting Chestnuts. Yeah, Roasting Chestnuts. And then the fourth color is like a pinkish color and it's called Mistletoe. Yep. Mistletoe. And then the last color from that set is a dark, if you can see it, you can maybe see it in the sleeve. It's this dark purple color here. It's called Winter's Night. And the final color is from a different dyer, which is called Red Stag Fiber. This is actually a BFL base, while these are all 75-25 wool nylon. But this is a BFL and it is in the color Cherowhite. So that's their label. So what else, anything about this sweater? I knit this sweater in about 3 weeks, right around Christmas, right before the end of the year, I finished it. And I love it. I knit the size that fit my bust. It does have some positive ease, and but I just like the flowy, since it's fingering weight. I really, really like it. And yeah, I think that's all I have to really say about that. This is out of order, but these are, and they've been worn and washed. This is a pair of socks I knit during the summer. It is a crazy sock lady pattern. Oh man, it's on the tip of my tongue. I'll link it down below. I can't think of the pattern name right now, but it's a popular one. It's not her morning coffee socks. It's a different pattern. I just can't remember what it's called. But this is knit out of a sock set by, or not a sock set, a mini and a sock yarn. The main color is from Life in the Longrass, and it's called Rose Gold. This is her label. And I knit these during summer sock camp, and I love them. I've also got a shorty pair with this main color and some stripes. It's dirty right now, but I did knit a shorty pair as well that matches these to use up the rest of the yarn. So there's that. And then the theme of this video is using every last bit of yarn. So I think that'll probably be the title, is using every last stitch. But from the leftovers from Mrs. Patmore's Kitchen, I did pair it with the mini from the sock set, and I made some journey socks by Heidi and Lana. This was my first pair of journey socks. They have been worn and washed, so they're a little bit fuzzy. But if you haven't seen this pattern, it's really, really cool construction, and it creates a no-show sock, but they do stay up. I really enjoy them. The only thing I ran into with these socks is I didn't quite have enough of the main color to make the foot as long as I would have liked. So my toe started a little sooner than I normally knit, but, I did the little pop of color on the heel, and I really love how these turned out. So I did finish those. All right. Last finished object from me is this little scrunchie. It's the Spruce Scrunchie. The Spruce Scrunchie by Heidi and Lana. I did knit that in some of the leftovers of my red stag yarn from my sweater. And I knit it with the recommended needle size, which is a US 2 9-inch circular. And I bound off a little bit too tight. It has zero stretch to it. So when you stretch the hair tie, my bind off is a little bit restrictive, but I learned my lesson, and on the next one, I will do a better job on that. But this is a really cute pattern for just using scraps, right? And making sure that we use the last of every bit of yarn, because we love it and it costs money and might as well use it, right? So that's my last finished object that I'm going to show today. Now, I do have another finished object, but I did not knit this. My mom did. And it's in theme with this video because she also used the red stag yarn. And she held it double with a cone of woolly knit that I have here. It is called Foxglove is the colorway. I love it. It's such a deep, like, eggplanty purple. It's so pretty. I'm going to make a sweater out of it. But she knit me this cute one-by-one ribbed hat by Pearl Soho, free pattern. And she held the yarn double, and it's so warm. And I think there's actually still a little bit of this red stag yarn left. I don't know where it is right this moment, but that yarn made its way into three different projects so far. So it's my cute little hat. So she made that for me. She's been on a hat making kick and a dishcloth making kick. So it's fun to have someone to knit with. So that's that. All right. We're gonna move on to whips. I'm gonna scoot my chair of whips closer to me. So the first whip that I am going to show you is a half finished object, and it is the Diamondback Socks by the Crazy Sock Lady. I have finished one of them and started the second. The second one's in my purse, but this is in a sock set by Explorer Knits. And I finished this one during summer sock camp, did not finish the second one, and I need to finish it. I think I just started the gusset decreases on the second one, if I remember correctly. Knitting this on a size one, US one, and following the pattern. I will say with this pearl knit pattern, because that's all these diamonds are, is pearls and knits. I wish I would have gone down to 60 stitches on the needles instead of my normal 64, because this is a little bit big. So just if you knit this pattern, keep that in mind. But I do have that as a whip, a long-standing whip. The next thing I'm going to show you is kind of my main whip right now. So this is my Luna T. I meant to look up the designer since I'm filming this the second time, and I didn't do that. So I'll put it down below, but it is a beautiful pattern, broken rib pattern. I have finished both of the sleeves, and I am just working down until I run out of yarn on the body. It's not meant to be a super long body because it's meant to be tucked in to pants. So I will wear it with high-waisted slacks to work, and I'm just really, really excited. It does stretch. It has a ton of stretch. I'm knitting it on the recommended size needles, and the yarn that I am using is called Albertine by De Rurum Natura, and I think it's in the color Mulberry, maybe? It has a silk, it has wool and silk, 90% wool, 10% silk, and it's just it's a really good yarn to work with, and it's affordable. It only took 3 balls for this sweater, and I think they were $8 a ball. So overall, this sweater is really affordable, and it's really good quality. So highly recommend that yarn. The next whip I'm going to show you is my dishcloth that I am working on, which is the Essentials Dish Towel. Sorry, the Dish Towel by Heidi and Lana. I am using the recommended size needles. This accent color is from I Love This Cotton. I'm not sure of the colorway. I got it at Hobby Lobby. And then the main color is Yarn Bee Cotton in the color cream. So I'm working on that. I have this on hold because it uses the same needles as my Luna T. So I need to finish my Luna T, and then I will pick back up on knitting that dishcloth. The next whip is my crochet granny stripe blanket that I am making with all of my fingering weight scraps. So this is something that I have been working on for a little over a year now. Where this progress keeper is right here is where I was, where I ended last year. And so I've added a few stripes this year, but nothing too crazy. Because I finished this sweater at the end of the year, I added all of those in and added some in for some socks I finished, but that's really all I've finished so far this year. That's in fingering weight. So I love this blanket. I use a size D hook. I chained 302 stitches, and then I just do double crochets. I know some people do clusters. I don't, but I think that's okay. It's more lightweight, but I live in Texas, and so it's okay that it's more lightweight. I don't mind. I think it'll be okay. Next, I have some sock whips that I'm working on. So the first one, I actually technically sort of have finished a pair because I'm making me and my best friend matching socks. So the only difference is the toe and the heel are reversed, but the main color is the same. So this one is mine, this one is hers. She's got a little bit skinnier leg and smaller foot than me. So I did go down to 60 stitches and made a smaller foot on hers. But yeah, so this is out of a Homespun house. I can't remember the name of the yarn. I know that it's named after like an 80s song, but I can't remember what it's called. The sock set, I mean. It came with both minis and the main color. And I have cast it on her second sock, and I am working on the heel flap. So, and then I will cast on my second sock, and then those will be finished. So essentially I have a pair. I did do these during, sock camp, and then I kind of put it down and picked it back up, later on. So I think the one I'm working on is down in here somewhere. It's just kind of buried. Here we go. So this is the whip of the one I'm currently working on. And then the next whip is a half finished object as well. I'll just show you the one that I finished because it's easier than figuring out the mess that's in that bag. This is a self-striping yarn by Tiny Human Knits, and it's called Carols in the Snow. Highly, highly recommend. She does a great job with self-striping yarn. This is my first order from her, and I love it. This project has a funny story. So I got the 50 gram main skein with the 20 gram mini, and I thought I had figured out what I would need in terms of the length of the leg, right? I did not take into consideration the fact that I wasn't doing a contrast cuff or something. I measured something wrong. And when I started the second, I realized I was gonna be short on yarn. I went on my Instagram and did like a call out because I was desperate on how I should fix it. And Whitney from Moonglow was like, hey, I just used that same yarn and I have, I think, exactly the amount you need to finish. I'll ship it to you. So I paid for shipping and she sent it to me and I get to finish my socks now. So I have cast on the second one of these. I'm about to start the heel flap on that. So I finished the leg. They are not exactly matching, but you know, that's okay. This one starts with pink. This one starts with white. They're barely off, but it was the only option I had. So I will do the heel flap and then, finish that one up. So that one will be done hopefully by the next time I film. And then I have one more sock whip and one more sweater whip, and that will be all of the whips. So the last sock whip I am making for my youngest son's dad. He wanted a pair of socks. He knows I knit. When we were together, I used to knit, and I've never made him a pair of socks, and he's been begging. So I am making him one. So these are his socks. I'm almost done with the first one. I did knit a pretty long leg and I do an extra, like a deeper gusset for men's socks. So I did that and I am just a few rows away from starting his toe. This is knit with Treehouse Knits, one of her monthly colorways from 2021. So it's not available anymore, but I am so obsessed with how this yarn is knitting up. I think she did such a wonderful job dyeing it. Hopefully you guys can see that. It's beautiful. So I'm enjoying working on that just because the yarn is so much fun to work with. I'll show you it in the cake. It's so pretty. Hopefully there's not like a shadow on that. Okay, and I did make these bags. By the way, it is a pattern that I follow off of YouTube by Erica Arndt called an easy pocket front drawstring or something like that. So I did make those. All right, last whip. There's not much done on it and it's a slow going project, but I'm pretty proud of it. So I figured I would show you guys. So this is the Aurelius sweater by Sari Nordland. It is an all over cable sweater. And I've never done a cabled sweater before. If you can see there, that's the back. You can see the cable panels. It's a raglan sweater. It's got these really pretty cabled raglans going down all the way around. You pick up the collar. I'm just really excited about it. So I've been slowly but surely chipping away on this. It does take me a lot of concentration and a lot of time. It is being knit out of a woolly knit held double in the color sage green. This is their 4-ply British wool, a 500 gram cone, and I'm holding it double. And yeah, it's going to be very warm, a very warm sweater. But I like working on it. If nothing else, I'm learning a new skill. So I enjoy it and we'll continue to chip away at that. It's probably going to be a whip for a very long time, but that's okay. Okay, so that is all my whips. So I will show you guys a couple of acquisitions that I have and future plans. We'll talk future plans and then we'll be done. All right, so in terms of acquisitions, there's obviously plenty that I have acquired over the last year, but just the ones of interest to show you is that I am a Patreon member with Heidi and Lana as of December, and I get the mini skeins and stitch marker subscription. So these are the yarns that I've received so far. This is the December Patreon colorway. This is January's, and then this is beautiful and it's February's. And I love how these go together. I'm thinking that I will keep them and collect them. And if the vibe continues, I will probably do a shawl or something, or maybe a striped sweater with a main color in between. That I think that these are just gorgeous. So those are the yarns. And then the stitch markers, they're little, cute little stitch markers. This is the December one. And then the January one is actually on my Luna tee. I don't know if y'all are gonna be able to see it, but it is right there. It's purple, it matched. So I went ahead and used it as my beginning of round marker. And then this one is the February one. So that is that. And then the other acquisition that I wanted to show you guys was that I saw this sweater on Instagram. It was one of those targeted ads. And it was so cute. And I was like, you know what? I could probably make it. They were sold out because I was probably going to buy it, but I didn't because they were sold out. So I was like, well, I could make it. So I went on a search and I found a yarn that I thought would look similar. It's a little bit darker base than what is the sweater that I saw, but I think it would still get the same effect because of the tweed and the bright colored tweed. This is Sueño Tweed by Haiku, and it is called Comforting Cream. And there are stripes in the sweater. I still need to get the stripes, the tonal colors for the stripes. I haven't gotten those yet. I think I'm just gonna get 50 grams of each color. And I got 3 skeins of this, and hopefully that's enough. I think I should have gotten 4, but I got 3, and we'll see how it goes. Maybe it will be a 3/4 length sweater of sleeves length sweater or something. It's a DK weight yarn, but it's a light DK. We'll see how it goes. So there's that. That is in future plans. Once I finish my Luna tee, that's probably something that I will cast on if I have the money in my budget to get the 2 colors I need. So that is everything that I'm going to show you guys for acquisitions. In terms of future plans, I do have a couple more socks that I want to make. So the first is just a vanilla sock. It's a self-striping yarn by Patons Kroy. It is called Midnight Orchid, and I absolutely love these colors. And then I have this, I don't know the dyer or the name of this, but I have this purple that I think pairs nicely with it for cuffs, toes, and heels. So I want to cast those on as soon as I finish a couple of pairs of socks that I'm currently working on. And then the other one that I want to do is the new pattern by the Crazy Sock Lady. I think they're called the Sweetheart Socks, maybe. She did them in her Vintage Valentine, the Moonglow Vintage Valentine sock set. And then she did another one that was just 2 colors. And I really liked the 2 color option. So I'm thinking that this Serendipity colorway by Treehouse Knits would be my main color. And then this would be my, this would really be the main, I guess this would be the contrast, but this would be the main color. And it is by Small Batch Yarns, which is my friend Elise again. And it is called, I haven't even looked at the name of this yarn in so long. It is called Dottie's BFF. Don't know if I'm gonna be able to get that back in there. Probably not. Okay, it's called Dottie's BFF, and I just think that the contrast will look really pretty on that sock. So I'll probably cast those on soon-ish. Maybe you'll see them next time. So that's everything, really, for what I've got going on. I can't think of anything else, so I appreciate you guys watching. Hopefully this video finishes recording and doesn't shut down on me. But you should see more of me. That's the plan. I do enjoy filming, and I need to do a better job of keeping up with it. I also plan to share some of like my budgeting stuff, which is, you know, something new for this channel, but I do think that it's something that I've helped a lot of my friends get started on. It's something that I love to do. And as hobbyists, we have to find room in our budget for our hobbies. So I feel like it kind of goes with, you know, being able to afford the hobby that I love. And so you'll probably see some videos like that for me in terms of cash stuffing and budgeting. So look forward to that. I hope you'll subscribe. I hope that you'll like this video if you enjoyed it, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.